Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to Allen Avenue Unitarian Universalist Church's in-person and online worship. Whether today is your first time here or you've been coming for years, we're so glad you are with us. My name is Ann Packard. My pronouns are she and her, and I am a member of the Board of Trustees. We are a growing community that transforms lives through the power of love. Our mission calls us to celebrate diversity, encourage spiritual growth, and promote social responsibility while we travel on and care for the earth. A special welcome to those of you at home who are joining us on Zoom today. If you're attending for the first time, please go to our website and fill out the welcome card so that we can know more about you. Now we invite you all to take this opportunity to silence your cell phones so that we can be fully present to one another. After the service, this is a little different today. We're gonna have a special brunch. So stay with us, please join in conversation. We're gonna go out to our outdoor fellowship space and mingle. For those of you on Zoom, you can stay on and connect with one another via Zoom. And now let us center our hearts and minds with the ringing of the chime.
Good morning. What a gift to be together. I am Reverend Tara, if I don't know you yet. I use they, them pronouns, and I am the minister here at Allen Avenue UU Church, A2U2 for short. And I am joined in leadership this morning by Emily, our Director of Religious Education, and Dale, our Director of Music. And this morning's worship is truly a celebration. It is a celebration designed with all ages in mind. So there is no separate RE program this morning. However, if any of our kids would prefer to play in the nursery, they are welcome to make their way back there at any point. That being said, it is truly a joy to be together with members and friends of all ages in the sanctuary this morning. The wiggles and noises that the youngest among us make are a sign of life, are a sign of the vibrancy and the life of this multi-generational community where all are welcome and cherished as full members and participants. And we remember that a noisy church is a healthy church. Amen. Today is the final Sunday of the church program year, and beginning next Sunday, we will shift to summer mode with weekly services here, same time, same place, and on Zoom led by A2U2 members and friends. And it is the tradition in this congregation to celebrate the Unitarian Universalist Flower Communion on this last Sunday. Yes, you are supposed to be holding on to your flowers. If you already brought them up, I forgive you. We're Unitarian Universalists. This year, we also celebrate two of our young people as we mark with ritual and with blessing their bridging from youth to young adulthood. And we mark another ending as well, the completion of our shared 2 years of transitional ministry together. For those newer to this community, a little context because I'm not going anywhere. I began my ministry here in the fall of 2022 with the intention of a 1 year transitional ministry, which turned into 2 years. It was clear that we are well matched, not perfect, but well matched for each other, and that we care deeply about one another. And so I will shift into a longer term role as your developmental minister starting in August. Developmental ministry is extended transitional work oriented around goals of congregational health and thriving with the intention of shared ministry that lasts about 4 to 7 years. So we're ending a thing and we're beginning a new adventure come fall. And so later in the service, we will release one another from our covenant that we entered into in the fall of 2022 to create space for a new ministry to blossom when we regather. And so as you arrive, friends, in this moment, I invite you to take a deep breath. We are at a threshold. Each of us in our own way. We are in a threshold moment, a moment of endings and a moment of beginnings. This is holy ground. Come and be welcome. You are joyfully called to worship.
As we light our sanctuary chalice this morning, those worshiping at home are invited to light a candle or a chalice near you to connect us to one another. Within the heart of the flower, the fountain of beauty. Within the heart of community, a fire that burns and dances. Within the heart of each of us, a spark of the spirit of life. Holy, holy, holy.
Our second candle this morning, our candle of community, is lit in honor of Father's Day. For the fathers among us, for those we have lost, who we miss, for the fathers that let us down, and for those who yearn to be, for the two dad families and the no dad families, and the families who have broken through binaries and this day is kind of irrelevant. However your heart this day, know that you are held in love. Will you take a breath with me? Our opening hymn is 1008 in your teal hymnal and up on the screen, When Our Heart is in a Holy Place. Dale will play it through once, and you are invited to rise in body or in spirit as we join our voices in song. Thank you. Each spring, when we celebrate the Unitarian Universalist Flower Communion, we remember the story of the Christian turned Unitarian Norbert and Maya Čapek, who upon returning to Czechoslovakia after the First World War, realized the traditional ritual of bread and wine communion would no longer serve their growing theological diversity of their congregation. Čapek turned to the beauty of the countryside, to the beauty of flowers, and developed the flower ceremony. He asked his congregants, like I have asked you, to bring a flower to church from their gardens, the field, or the roadside, or the church garden. See a lot of peonies up in here, my beloveds. And to place their flowers in a vase, which we will do in a moment. There was the church community, no less unique for being united. Following the service, each person could take a flower from the common vase, a different one than they had brought. And so at this time, Emmett and whoever emerges as a helper will collect our flowers. You are invited to pass your flowers to either aisle, so somewhere where someone can walk through and get it. So Emmett and anyone else who would like to help will come through and collect them and arrange them in the front of the room in the vases. Take a look at that. Just as we bring our many different flowers, all glorious in their own ways, we together this morning also bring our unique selves to this community, to this gathered group of beloved souls. We come to be part of something greater and more beautiful than we could ever be alone. Would you join me in the spirit of prayer? I share this morning the words of Elizabeth Strong. Enter into the communion of flowers with joyful hearts. Enter with reverent thoughts. It has taken long months beneath cold ground for these flowers to prepare their blooming. It has taken each of us long times of growth through sorrow and joy to prepare for our living now. The blooming season is short. The flowers stay only a brief time. We are travelers upon the earth, travelers through all to brief lifetimes. Therefore, let our moments be bountiful. Let us rejoice in our unique colors, aromas, and sounds. Let us celebrate together in love, that as we travel away, we take with us the memory of golden hours together among the flowers. In the spirit of love, I pray. Amen.
Thank you.
We are a freely gathered, open, and welcoming faith community, supported by your contributions. Each week, one-third of our offering is given away to a nonprofit organization whose missions aligns with our Unitarian Universalist values. This month's Share the Plate recipient is the Yellow Tulip Project, a youth-driven movement dedicated to smashing the stigma surrounding mental illness. You can find more information in your order of service. Donations can be made now as the basket is passed through the donation button on our website, or if you are a member on Breeze. If giving through Breeze, please note if the donation is for your pledge or a gift to our Share the Plate. If you are visiting us for the first time this morning, please know that your presence is your gift to us. At this time, our offering will be collected and gratefully received.
Thank you.
First two verses of our closing hymn, Love Will Guide Us, 131 in your gray hymnal and up on the screen. Dale will play it through once and then we'll sing together.
Some of you might remember that in September of 2022, we joined in covenant with Reverend Tara at the beginning of our shared ministry. Reverend Tara made promises to us, and we made promises in return.
You welcomed me as your partner in ministry.
We, as a community, promised to use our hands and hearts, our vision and voices to help and not harm this beloved community through this time of transition. We promised to share our portions of truth with Reverend Tara and to listen deeply to what they said, that we may grow in understanding.
I promised to share my portions of truth with you, to listen deeply to what you said, that I may grow in understanding.
We promised we would dare to disagree agreeably with Reverend Tara, to dream what we may become, and to venture down some untried paths as we made ready to as we made ready for that which is to come.
I promised I would dare to speak hard truths to you as best as I could discern them, to hold up a mirror so you could see your past and present clearly, and to make some empty space here for the new to enter in. We prayed that in this brief and precious time, that we might be a blessing to each other and a blessing to the world.
We did all of this and more in our 2 years of transitional work together.
We have worked faithfully and imperfectly and joyously together. I have made mistakes. I will make more mistakes. You will too. We will together. It's part of the journey. It's how we learn, how we are made new. There have been tears and laughter, anxiety, fun, frustration, deep learning, and profound transformation. You have challenged me and loved me into being a new minister, a minister ready to answer the call of developmental ministry here with you in this beloved community. In some ways, friends, we are all bridging. This time together, this time of transition, of being together in this particular way is ending. A new way of being together, a new set of tasks and goals, and the deepening of relationship awaits us.
And so it is time to release Reverend Tara, and for Reverend Tara to release us from this covenant of transitional ministry, to create space for the promises and callings of new beginnings to emerge. Let us join together in speaking the words on the screen.
We acknowledge that this period of transition, this leg of the journey, is complete. With appreciation for all we have learned, with hope in the present and faith in our future, we look forward to new beginnings. With joy and gratitude, may it be so.
And if we could have Anne join us.
We invite you over here to the corner. We're not going to put you in the corner, but we'll let you out. Reverend Tara, in recognition of your moving from being our transitional minister to a new shared ministry with us, we present you with this gift from all of the members of Allen Avenue Unitarian Universalist Church.
Thank you, Reverend Tara.
Let's sing more. Now we're going to sing the last verse of Love Will Guide Us, number 131. Now, as Dale plays our postlude and I extinguish our chalice, I'll extinguish those first so that we don't light sleeves on fire. All are invited to come forward and take a flower, different from the one you brought, and let us celebrate the beauty of this place and the beauty of one another. Our worship has ended, and our service begins. Go in love.